In this video, we'll take a look at how to interpret a p-value. So what is a p-value? P-value stands for probability value. It indicates how likely it is that a result occurred by chance alone. If the p-value is small, it indicates the result was unlikely to have occurred by chance alone. These results are known as being statistically significant. A small p-value means that it is greater than chance alone. Something happened, the test is significant. Whereas a large p-value indicates that the result is within chance or normal sampling error. Or in other words, nothing happened, the test is not significant. And p-values range from 0 to 1. Let's go ahead and take a look at some p-values of popular computer output. So here's SPSS, and the p-value is given where it says sig two-tailed. And it's very small in this example at 0.002. Now we'll formalize this in a minute, but for now, that's beyond chance, it's quite small, so we would say that the result is statistically significant. Taking a look at another example, here we see a p-value reported as sig once again in SPSS as 0.268. Now that's not really that small. So that's within normal sampling error, we would say, or it's not beyond chance. So the result is not statistically significant. Now to formalize this, we want to look at what is known as alpha. And when we interpret whether a p-value is significant, that is beyond chance, or not, we need to know the level of alpha being used for the test. The two most common levels are 0.05 for alpha or 0.01. Alpha is decided beforehand by the researcher or analyst. So if we use an alpha of 0.05, the following rule applies. If p, or sig, as you saw in our output, is less than alpha, or less than 0.05 in this case, the test is significant. Whereas if p or sig is greater than 0.05, the test is not significant. So as an example, if we had a p-value or a sig of 0.03, using the rule up above with an alpha 0.05, would the test be significant or not? Well, the test would be significant, right? Because 0.03 is less than 0.05. Let's go ahead and take a look at another example. So if we have a p of 0.12 now with alpha 0.05, try and assess whether or not that test would be significant. It would not be significant because 0.12 is greater than 0.05. So it's not significant, or it's not beyond sampling error. And here's a table of some different outcomes. So looking at this first row, if we had a p of 0.04 and we use alpha 0.05 in all decisions, this is less than 0.05, so we would say it's significant. Our second value, 0.075, that's greater than 0.05, right? So we would say that's not significant. 0.049, that's very close, but it is less than 0.05, so that would be significant. And then 0.523, that's definitely greater than 0.05, so it's not significant. And then finally, 0.001, definitely less than 0.05, so this result is significant. Now, if we look at alpha 0.01, we use really the same decision rule. If p is less than alpha, this time alpha is 0.01, though, the test is significant. Whereas if p is greater than alpha, the test is not significant. So if we have an example here with a p of 0.04, using alpha 0.01, we would see that the test is not significant because 0.04 is greater than 0.01. If we had an example of 0.003, we would see that it is significant in this case because 0.003 is less than 0.01. So let's go ahead and take a look at some examples as well with alpha 0.01. So here we have a p of 0.001. That's definitely less than alpha of 0.01, so it's significant. 0.02, it's close, but it's greater than 0.01, so it's not significant. 0.009, once again, quite close, but less than alpha points 0.01, so it's significant. 0.523 is greater than 0.01, so it's not significant. And then finally, 0.012, close once again, but it is greater than 0.01, so it's not significant. Okay, let's look at a p-value again in SPSS. So now we have a p of 0.002, and it's very small. Let's assess this for significance using alpha 0.05. So because 0.002 is less than 0.05, the test is significant at alpha 0.05. Now, before we close, ask yourself, would it have been significant if alpha 0.01 was used? Well, since 0.002 is less than 0.01, the test would be significant if an alpha 0.01 was used as well. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching.